We can see any object only when light is coming from either object to our eyes, like a candle. When the light coming from the candle hits the eyes, then we see the candle. Or the light is hitting an object and coming back to our eyes. In both conditions, the object is visible to us only when the light comes back to our eyes. If the light does not come back to the eye after hitting an object, then that object is invisible or black to us. Black is not a color, but black appears in the absence of light. This means that any object which is black does not transmit any kind of radiation. So what is the blackbody radiation? In this video of quantum mechanics, we will learn about blackbody radiation. At the same time, we will also understand how it got us to introduce a new type of physics which we call quantum mechanics. So let's start the video. Whenever a radiation hits an object, three types of physical phenomena can be possible. Either the radiation hits the body and reflected back, or transmitted through the body, or absorbed in the body itself. Here, we will focus only on reflection and absorption of the radiation. Radiation consists of many different wavelengths, some of which can be identified by their color, such as the visible ray, which has seven colors, while there is no color in the radiation of some wavelength. For example, infrared, X-ray, gamma ray, radio wave, etc. Now, pay attention. Any object emits radiation only when the temperature of that object is higher than its surrounding. Like a candle. When we light up a candle, it has a higher temperature than its surrounding room. Similarly, the temperature of the sun is more than its surrounding space. But there is a difference in the radiation of both. Radiation coming from the candle has a wavelength of mostly yellow color, while sun emits radiation of all wavelengths. The sun emits radiation of all wavelengths. When its radiation hits an object, it absorbs some part of the radiation and reflects back the rest of the radiation. The amount of radiation that an object absorbs is called the absorption coefficient of that object, which indicates how much of the radiation is absorbed. It can be 20%, 50% or 80%. If 100% of the radiation occurring on an object is absorbed, it is called a perfect black body. The absorption coefficient of such an object is 100%. In the ideal case, a black body can absorb the radiation of all types of wavelengths. Carbon black is an object that can absorb 99% of the incident radiation. Now we come back to our question. What is a blackbody radiation? So, whenever a radiation is absorbed by a blackbody, due to this absorption, the temperature of that body also increases. As a result, the temperature of that body increases in comparison of its surrounding. In this condition, blackbody starts emitting radiation. This radiation is called blackbody radiation. Here, it is to be kept in mind that this is not only done by the blackbody. Rather, when any object absorbs radiation, it starts emitting radiation itself due to the temperature being increased. So, any object emits radiation due to the increment in temperature, then this radiation is called blackbody radiation. Our sun is a perfect black body because it emits radiation of all type of wavelength. Scientists made a black body in the lab that could absorb up to 99.9% of the radiation. For this, a hollow sphere was taken, which has a narrow hole. The inner surface of this sphere is coated with the carbon black. When the radiation comes inside through this narrow hole, the radiation hits the wall of the sphere and gets absorbed 99%. The remaining radiation reflects back and collides with the wall again. In this way, in each collision, 99% of the radiation is absorbed. Due to the absorption of radiation, its temperature also increases. As a result of this, it starts emitting radiation from the narrow hole, in which all wavelengths are present. This radiation is called blackbody radiation. When this radiation from the blackbody was traced on the graph, classical mechanics failed to explain this curve. Then Max Planck explained it by introducing quantum mechanics. In our next video, we will know how classical mechanics failed to explain the radiation curve. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe our channel.